as I'm humbled to bring to the podium, he is the president of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, Dr. Charles Steele.
My brother and sisters, I'm so happy to be here and honored. Mr. Louis Farrakhan is a great friend. I'd like to also recognize my good friend, Mayor Johnny Ford. Give him a big round of applause, Mayor Johnny Ford. His son to Hank Sanders and his lovely wife Rose, who keeping the movement alive. They're still on the battlefield. Ladies and gentlemen, let me just tell you a story, and I'm going to sit down. In the spirit of Dr. Martin Luther King, as president, CEO of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, it is a tough job. Many times those you think are with you, they're just smiling in your face. They're not truly your friends. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just live being president and CEO of SCLC for 24 hours. I got a story to tell. I couldn't miss today. When I got to the Southern Christian Leadership Conference 2004, I began to try and organize Dr. King's organization. The headline said, "What is Steele coming to Atlanta for? SCLC is dead. Only thing that can say SCLC is God Himself." But ladies and gentlemen, I pray. Matter of fact, I gave a prayer just the other day. I said, "Lord, thank you so much for not letting me look like what I've been through." Hello, somebody. Thank you, Lord. You don't see the scars in my face. You don't see the bullets in my back. Just thank you, Lord. But in 2005, when I didn't have no money, and I had a suit and a tie on, just trying to fake it till I make it, because I had a mission to save the organization that freed us. But everybody said, "We don't need SCLC no more. Those days are over." Well, I'm announcing today, ladies and gentlemen, that the union of SCLC and the Civil Rights Movement and the Nation of Islam is together. We are united. Nobody will separate us. Nobody will give us the rhetoric that we don't need Minister Louis Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam. We ain't going nowhere. Let me say this, and I'm going to go to my seat. When we were broke and didn't have no money, hello, somebody. It's a horrible feeling when you ain't got no money. And especially when you're running an organization like the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. When the lights are cut off, oh, they don't want to hear the truth. When the phones are cut off, you can't meet payroll, and folks got to meet and feed their families. God told me, make the call to Chicago. Mrs. Farrakhan, I made the call to the palace. This little country boy from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, had to make the call. I called Minister Farrakhan. I said, "Minister, I need to meet with you, with Reverend Avalon, my special assistant at the time." I said, "We want to just come and give you our vision for Dr. King's organization." Now, you know I was not going to tell him we were broke over the phone. Let me take my pockets out. Ain't nothing in them. Dr. King organization is broke. Now I call a lot of other folks. So-called God-fearing folks. Hello, somebody. Y'all know what I'm talking about. As my grandmama said, they told Bible folks. Read scripture and quote. I say, minister, we're broke. We don't have any money. But if you loan me some money for Dr. King's organization, I can keep the doors open. I'll pay you back in 90 days. The minister said, still, if you want the money, you can't pay me back. You can never pay me back. In the spirit of Dr. King, he called his secretary. He said, pay me my checkbook. And I said, oh, hallelujah. Oh, the Lord is up in here. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I did a holy dance on that plane. I didn't do it in front of the mess. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, do you know the feeling? I'm finished. But you need to know the story, because the minister will never tell you. This is Dr. King's organization that you say you love, and nobody will give a quarter. Nobody will give a dime. Matter of fact, one lady called me. Who you think you are? The rest of them couldn't save it? You can't either. But when I went back to Alabama, and then I made my way back to Atlanta, I had the money, I had the check, and somebody in my office said, we can't take that check. I said, why can't we? We can't take no money from Minister Louis Farrakhan. I said, madam, where you gonna be in 45 minutes? She said, I'm gonna be right here. I said, well, you know that bank right around the corner? You watch me, because we're going to deposit that check. Minister Farrakhan said, still, after I give you this check, you're going to raise a lot of money. Everybody called me a fundraiser now. But it ain't me. It was Minister Farrakhan. But after that, I raised $20 million, built a brand new SCLC International Headquarters. Hello, somebody. Don't tell me God ain't good and he's not using Mr. Louis Farrakhan. I love the Lord. I love the Lord. And I love Mr. Farrakhan. Fired up. Fired up. Fired up. Ain't gonna take it no more.
Give our brother another round of applause.